Hello, people on the internet, or wherever you may be. I'm Guthrie Govan, guitarist from the UK, and what I'm brandishing before you today is a rather odd-looking instrument made by French people, specifically the good folks at Vigier. Not like other guitars, it's fretless, although some pedantic types have pointed out in the past that it actually has one giant fret. Looks kind of cool. I just thought I'd spend a moment trying to tell you what kind of things you might want to explore if you walk into a shop and see one of these and want to try it for the first time. Obviously, in Indian classical music or Turkish classical music, people have been playing fretless instruments forever. And in the string section of an orchestra, again, violins, cellos, all that good stuff, fretless instruments. But in our crazy world of rock and roll, this is quite a young instrument and no one's quite sure how you're meant to play it yet. So I'm still learning myself. I'm still trying to work out what works and what doesn't. So what I've discovered so far is the first thing you have to do on a fretless guitar is just check that you can play in tune, just playing regular notes. No vibrato, no bending, nothing like that. Just and the trick there seems to be not to think about it too much. I think mostly your fingers remember roughly where the notes are from their previous experience playing a fretted instrument. So what you have to do with one of these is not to be too distracted by the fact that there is fretlessness. There's some helpful markers here along the side. There's a little notch where every fret would be and the familiar position marking dots at the 5th fret, 7th fret, etc. One thing to remember, I guess, if you're a blues or rock guitarist, maybe your fingers approach the strings at that kind of angle, and you have to remember that the frets, were they here, would in fact be at this angle. So you have to think in a straight line that way rather than this way whenever you're crossing strings. And apart from that, there's an element of something resembling singing in the sense that you play the note, listen to it coming out of the amp, and then if you can monitor immediately whether it needs to be sharpened or flattened a little bit. And you can almost do that just by rolling the fingertip from side to side. So if there's a small discrepancy in your pitching, you should be able to fix it without doing anything too drastic. Then if you want to try bending notes, don't do that, because these come with 12s as standard, and I think you could actually put heavier strings than that. One of the crazy French innovations is to put this graphite strip in the back of the neck, which, to quote Zappa, renders it totally insensitive to climatic changes. It's a very stable neck, doesn't mind 12-gauge strings at all. But if you try to bend them this way, it will hurt and not really achieve anything. No. The way forward is to bend like that, just by sliding up and down the fretboard. So you might want to translate some of your favorite blues licks, and then of course you realize you can bend as far as you like. The joys of having no fret, there's really no pain threshold you reach after a certain number of semitones. So you might then want to explore what you can do just phrasing differently by trying to join up different parts of the neck. If you listen to anything resembling Indian music, or indeed any of the great slide players, you've probably noticed that those guys play more along one string rather than keeping in one scale position on the neck. So there's a lot of fun you can have there. And the sustain is surprisingly good because of this mysterious alloy that they use for the fretboard. The harder your fretboard is, well, fingerboard, the longer the notes ring out. So even on the top E string, It's an odd sound, but it's usable, and there's certainly some sustain there. If you want to go crazy, if you're the experimental type, you might want to throw one of these into the mix. This, of course, is an Ebow. Maybe front pickup, toned down a little bit, and you get... You could add in some volume pedal just to hide the beginning of each note. So this thing is keeping the string sustaining the whole time. I can fade it in like that. Sooner or later, everyone wants to have a go at playing chords, and that can be a little bit soul-destroying. Some chords work better than others. Something like this, the old-fashioned A-shaped bar chord, is almost doomed to fail because you need all those fingers basically stacked on top of each other, and what they want to do is be like that. So you might want to re-finger it this way. Or that one, the E-shaped chord, these two fingers again, you have to get them on top of each other like that. Kind of painful. So you might just go through all the chord shapes you normally play and then put a big black cross against the ones which are unlikely to work when you try them on a fretless. And then just enjoy chords like that, which seem to work rather nicely. So what else can you do with fretless? You can try maybe a little bit of wah-wah. That seems to work quite well and give everything a more vocal quality. You could maybe try to copy some slide licks without a slide. And the trick there is maybe to pick a chord shape like that to synthesize the effects of having an open tuning and then treat that as your bass. So you can zoom up and down. I know some people approach this instrument in terms of trying to get microtones, either trying to play normal Western music more in tune than you can with equal temperament, or just to be a little bit crazy and try something different. I'm more interested in trying to get it to sound in tune, but then use the fretlessness to accentuate the way I get from one note to another. But of course, it is great for any bluesy type phrasing where you want to bend the minor third or the minor seventh a bit sharp, or the fifth a little bit flat to make it sound more authentic. So. So yeah, just a few little things you might want to experiment with. So if you ever meet one of these, it's called a surfretter, despite what it says here, Excalibur. It's a Vigier surfretter. You'll know it when you see it because it will have this crazy looking fingerboard. I hope you have fun messing around with it and deciding whether a guitar like this is for you or not. I'm having a lot of fun with it. I hope to make another video like this in about 10 years when I've learned how to play it properly. Cheers, have fun.